Okay, so this is our first class diagram.
So let me ask you something about what we've done so far. I also sent, in what I sent you, I also had some stories about how the actual library is used. You asked me to do that, and are we going to use that here?
I'm glad you asked, actually. Yeah, those are, you know, what we call use cases, what we will use as scenarios, kind of things that we will use to derive use cases. And they're also a very good way of extracting requirements. We're not going to look at them right now, because now we're more working on kind of the static structure of the system. But after we're done with the class diagram, you know, we'll do it at a different time. But we're going to use those to see how the library is actually used and see whether we can get more information that we can use to refine our requirements based on that.
Okay.
So for now, we'll just focus in on the structure. But those, you know, I'm glad you sent them because they're going to be very useful as well. Okay, so let's see. Well, first of all, I mean, it seems like this is already pretty crowded, right? We have a number of classes. So let's see if there's some class that maybe is superfluous and or we can model in a different way. So for example, while thinking of this, I was thinking the library card, I mean, it doesn't really contain much information, right? So is it basically just a number?
Card has a number on it. We have a separate vendor that does that for us, so it doesn't need to be part of this system. We just have to make sure that every patron has a library card.
Okay, so basically for you, in a sense, the library card is just an ID that gets associated
with the patron, right? That's right.
So I think that the best way to represent this, I mean, unless you need an entity because you are creating it yourself, but it seems like you're not, I will just remove this one. And I would like to put this, so basically to take the library card number and add it to the patron.
Okay, makes sense.
Okay, so I'll add it here and as an additional attribute. Okay, and we'll eliminate this class.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, and wait a second. So I guess also the child needs a library card number, right?
Child needs a library card number, but let me ask you about that.
Okay.
Is child a separate class or is it just another kind of patron?
Oh, I see. Because, yeah, it is sort of a special patron, right? And so maybe we should represent it as a kind of a refinement of the patron. But that made me think. So what is the only thing that characterizes children? Is it just the age?
Well, and if they can't check out more than 5 books.
Okay, and the only difference is the fact that they're less, you know, than 12 year old, right?
12 or less, right?
12 or less. So I guess, you know, I would probably like to represent this by making the age explicit in the patron rather than represented as a class. And I'll tell you why. Because one of the issues, and that might happen again, is that basically there are patrons that are children and they're no longer children when they become 13 or older, right?
Right.
And if we represent them with a separate class in a sense, then we cannot really change the type of an instance of these classes. So we'll have to kind of destroy the patron, create a new one. So that means that we'll also have to transfer any history. We want to keep history and so on. So I think I kind of like better the idea that I would represent the age explicitly in the patron, and then I'll behave differently based on whether the patron is 12-year-old or younger or 13-year-older or older. Do you see any problem with that?
It makes things a little simpler.
Okay, and actually it allows us also to eliminate one class here. So I'm going to proceed this way. So I'm going to eliminate the children class and I'm going to put the age in the patron. Okay, and let me see. So in this spirit, actually, something else that jumps at me is this idea of the bestseller, because I kind of feel like we might have the same problem. So what's the story? What is a bestseller?
Well, it's an item that we want to restrict how long people can keep because there's such demand for it.
I see. And so basically a book that is a bestseller, like the New York Times bestseller, is a bestseller forever?
No. It's hot for a while and then it becomes just a regular item.
Ah, I see. Then I guess it's a similar situation to the one I was mentioning before, right?
Okay.
That if we have a book, it will have to kind of change its type if it becomes a bestseller. Then we'll have to change its type again if it's no longer a bestseller.
Right.
So it seems to me that a better way to represent this is just to eliminate this bestseller class. And instead, I'm going to put the bestseller attribute, which will be just a Boolean, in the book.
Okay. What do you mean by Boolean?
Right, we don't know what the Boolean is, right? The Boolean is basically just a number that can have two values, right? True or false.
Okay.
So we usually normally use it in this case. I mean, imagine 1, 0, right? And it's just kind of the basic, you know, the bits, right?
Okay.
So this is just telling us, it's like a flag that is telling us this book is a bestseller or not.
Okay.
And it's very easy to change this value and make a book a bestseller or not a bestseller than just creating and destroying, you know, instances of these classes.
Okay. Makes sense.
Okay, so at this point, this looks already better, right? Because we have less classes, and I think we did some serious cleanup. That's good. Okay, so now that we eliminated some of this, what I like to do, as I said, we're going to both clean up but also refine. I'd like to go back to our requirements and see whether we can identify additional attributes for these classes that maybe are not as obvious as the one that we saw so far.
Okay.